And it's good to see so many old Birmingham friends here, people we collected for the miners in 1984-5. And I'm here from the Coalition of Resistance, which is a broad united community and workplace campaign, sister organisation to Right to Work. We're against cuts and privatisation. We were founded by Tony Benn in August 2010. We're here from the Coalition of Resistance to announce the beginning of the end of the Condem government. We're here to give that message to David Cameron, that ordinary bloke who just happens to be the great, 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 great grandson of William IV and fifth cousin twice removed to Queen Elizabeth II. David Cameron, with a family fortune of 30 million, has absolutely no conception what it means to exist on Job Seeker's allowance. Yet he's planning to wreck the lives of hundreds of thousands of public sector workers by condemning them to a reduced Job Seeker's allowance. A sector where 65% of the workers are women and where the majority of black workers are employed. Cameron, the compassionate conservative, has no idea what it means to survive on basic state pension. Yet he's going to raid those pensions to the tune of 8,000 per pensioner by changing from RPI to CPI. One change of letter. He talks about fairness, yet his cuts will hit the poorest 10% by 20p in the count and the richest 10% by only 1.5p in the pound. He talks about protecting the vulnerable, yet his odious education minister, Gove, the one with the charm of a minnow, has closed down the school buildings program. The scale of these cuts is driven by ideology, not necessity. Just as George W. Bush wanted to complete his father's agenda, so Cameron wants to complete Thatcher's agenda. They want to dismember the state. They're planning to cause misery for millions to save capitalism for the millionaires. The national government between 1929 and 1931 had the same policies, and it led to depression, fascism and war. And as other speakers have said, there are alternatives. Scrap Trident. Bring the troops back from Afghanistan. Catch the tax evaders. Tighten up on tax avoidance. Increase income tax for the rich, or at least for those on more than 100,000. Rather than sacking Inland Revenue staff, they should employ more staff to collect the tax from the rich. And they should sack their newly appointed advisor, Sir Philip Green of Arcadia, who recently avoided £300 million tax in 1 year by paying £1.2 billion into his wife's Monaco bank account. Now these Tories believe they're born to rule, and the Condems and the Lib Dems are pathetically grateful to have been asked to hang on to their coattails. But they have no mandate to dismantle the welfare state. What's more, this government is not invincible. It's very unstable. Many Lib Dem voters are furious that the Nick Clegg cabal has sold out the nation to further their own careers with seats in the cabinet. We brought down the Heath government with trade union action in the workplace. We defeated the poll tax on the streets and by a mass campaign of civil disobedience. I was in Birmingham at the time. I still haven't paid my poll tax. This time, with an alliance of Union Action and community campaigns, we will defend our public services and drive them from office. In the 60s, when I was very young, Macmillan was asked why he left office as leader of the Tories. And he said, "Events, dear boy, events." Well, we've got lots of events planned. We need to organise lots and lots of events to drive this shower out. Specifically, the Coalition of Resistance on the 20th of October is organising outside Downing Street with the support of other organisations when they announce their spending plans to show the government that they will not be with us for long. From all these actions, I'm sure, and I've been around a long time, I'm sure we will build up to demonstrations of hundreds of thousands, which will dwarf the poll tax protests and wipe the ugly smiles off their smug faces. So, from the Coalition of Resistance, in solidarity with the Right to Work campaign, I say, join the resistance! Yeah.